The odor from the flower is gone, which like thy kisses breathed on me. The color from the flower is flown, which glowed of thee and only thee. A shriveled, lifeless, vacant form, it lies on my abandoned breast, and mocks the heart which yet is warm with cold and silent rest. I weep, my tears revive it not. I sigh, it breathes no more on me. Its mute and uncomplaining lot is such as mine should be. The world is too much with us, late and soon. Getting and spending, we lay waste our powers. Little we see in nature that is ours. We have given our hearts away, a sordid boon. The sea that bears her bosom to the moon, the winds that will be howling at all hours, and are upgathered now like sleeping flowers. For this, for everything, we are out of tune. It moves us not, great God. I'd rather be a pagan suckled in a creed outworn. So might I, standing on this pleasant lea, have glimpses that would make me less forlorn. Have sight of Proteus rising from the sea, or hear old Triton blow his wreathed horn. Thank you. Barely a 12 months after the 7 days' war that put the world to sleep, late in the evening the strange horses came. By then we had made our covenant with silence, but in the first few days it was so still. We listened to our breathing and were afraid. On the second day, the radios failed. We turned the knobs. No answer. On the third day, a warship passed us, heading north, dead bodies piled on the deck. On the sixth day, a plane plunged over us into the sea. Thereafter, nothing. The radio's dumb, and still they stand in corners of our kitchens, and stand, perhaps, turned on in a million rooms all over the world. But now, if they should speak, if on a sudden they should speak again, if on the stroke of noon a voice should speak, we would not listen. We would not let it bring that old bad world that swallowed its children quick at one great gulp. We would not have it again. Sometimes we think of the nations lying asleep, curled blindly in an impenetrable sorrow, and then the thought confounds us with its strangeness. The tractors lie about our fields at evening. They look like dank sea monsters crouched and waiting. We leave them where they are and let them rust. They'll molder away and be like other loam. We make our oxen drag our rusty plows, long laid aside. We have gone back far past our father's land. And then, that evening, late in the summer, the strange horses came. Distant tapping on the road, the deepening drumming. It stopped, went on again, and at the corner changed to a hollow thunder. Saw the heads. A wild wave charging, and we're afraid. We had sold our horses in our father's time to buy new tractors. Now they were strange to us as fabulous steeds set on an ancient shield or illustrations in a book of knights.
Now she's poisoned by demons. You can't.
We did not dare go near them, yet they waited, stubborn and shy, as if they had been sent by an old command to find our whereabouts and that long-lost archaic companionship. In the first moment, we had never thought that they were creatures to be owned and used. Among them were some half a dozen colts, dropped in some wilderness of the broken world, yet new as if they had come from their own Eden. Since then they have pulled our plows and borne our loads, but that free servitude can still pierce our hearts.
For your nest, for your love, did you
Our life's changed. They're coming, our beginning.